take a look at evolutionary models. Evolutionary models are very interesting. It talks about two different types, prototyping and spiral models. So what do you mean by prototyping and spiral models in evolutionary modeling? So let us talk about prototyping first. What is a prototype? Have you seen a prototype? I'm just showing an image of a prototype. So what is a prototype? For instance, in civil engineering, they always develop these prototypes. You see here, the prototype is very detailed. It's actually like the final construction, right? The building color, the trees, even they have some marking. Everything is actually like, it should resemble the final product. And it is at a smaller scale. And it is built at a rapid, faster rate. Why we create prototypes? Why we create prototypes? Understand requirements. Understand requirements. Say if I have not created this prototype, the user will not be able to visualize how that end product will be. He may say, after you say you didn't create a prototype, you finished the building. He may come and tell you, oh, why did you have so many windows here, or why this car parking is here? Some kind of minor issues or major issues may happen. So to get that clarification, we build prototypes in civil engineering. Likewise, yeah, we have a prototype definition too. What is a prototype? It is an early sample or model built to test concept or a process, to act as a thing to be replicated or learned from. So we learn from the prototype. That is very important. Prototyping serves to provide specifications for a real working system. Okay. Can we develop prototypes for software applications? See, we are making attendance management system. Should we wait for 1 year to get the system and the users to see, okay, this is attendance management, this is how it looks like. Can we go and develop a prototype like that? I saw this recent article on prototype building by Microsoft. And it's very interesting how to develop prototypes. It is using artificial intelligence to create prototypes. So this product is called Sketch to Code. It uses AI to convert handwritten drawings to working HTML prototypes. So I'll show you what this does. In the initial requirements gathering phase, you'll be sitting with your clients, you'll try to create the forms or something like this. By hand, you'll draw. Okay, for a registration form, you need this text box, text box, text box, what label you need. You draw this diagram, that becomes a prototype, right? What kind of output the user expects, or what kind of screen the user wants. So now this prototype can be taken, you can take a picture of that particular thing that you have drawn, and you can upload your design. Once when you upload your design, it starts generating the HTML code for you. It converts that to code. And then you see here, it finally gives you the HTML code. Now the user is able to see what you have drawn as a code, as a working, as a prototype. Immediately, okay, this is how it will be. And it's very useful, you know, I think I have, this is the site wherein you can go and they have given a sample to. You can just use or you can upload your design and create a prototype. And I think I have that here somewhere. This code, yeah, and this is the code that is getting generated by that prototype, and you see the entire code is just like that given from the prototype, and you can also go and visualize it in the browser. For instance, let me go to CSE 1005, and where is that particular thing, communications, yeah, result, okay, let me go and open this in the browser. I was just talking to the user, okay, you need a text box here, you need a submit button here, this is how the output should be. Then I took a picture, I made the prototype, I just used Sketch to Code, my form is now ready. The user can visualize, oh, okay, this is how it's going to be, fine. How quick? And you can always go and make some HTML code changes to see the color changes or font changes, you can get it. So the user can see how the attendance management system will actually look like even before you go and code it. So how easy it is. So prototyping, this one particular idea was interesting because they have used artificial intelligence in software engineering to develop prototypes. Very good. And we have other tools too for prototyping. That is one latest tool, Serena Prototype Composer and Wireframe. So if you go to this online link, you will go and get this particular area where you can just drag and drop. So I just drag and drop student name, address, some text box. So I can just select how my output will be looking like. No need to know even one line of code to develop this. Just drag and drop, your screen is ready. Users can see how your system is. So this kind of a development, what is this? This is totally different, right? User will be there with me. I'll be talking to him. You see the model changes. Get the requirements, design, implement. So the model is now, it's not like freezing requirements, going to design, going to testing. User will be there with me. Okay, what do you want? I'll go and design. Show the implementation. You will say some feedback, change. So now the user is totally involved. That becomes evolutionary model. What is evolutionary model? Quickly you do a requirements gathering, quickly you do a design, you show some output to the user. Where will you use such type of prototyping? Mostly? Mostly for UI designs you'll use. Sometimes you will not be clear about what kind of output the user wants. You can also go with a paper prototype. You know, just on a paper you can just draw and show. That's also paper-based prototype. Sometimes the user will expect something very peculiar. It may not be even existing. This kind of an interface I need. For that you have to develop a prototype. So that is prototyping. So what is this evolutionary thing? It's a circle. For instance, you will start with requirements, go to design, then go to some kind of output generation, and you will be getting the client's feedback. Okay. So there are two types of prototyping. You have exploratory development and throwaway prototyping. What is exploratory development? For instance, I showed you I have developed a form. How did I develop this form? Use Sketchbook code and then I created this form. What I can do is I can use the same form for my final system. I can just keep on revising it, build my final system. That becomes exploratory development. I sit with the client, change the code, change the code, change the code. Finally, I will get the final system. That is the final system I tell you. The next thing is throwaway prototyping. What is throwaway prototyping? I develop something. For instance, this can be throwaway prototyping. This example I have shown you. Where is that? This can be throwaway prototyping. Wireframe.cc. I am just creating a model here that no code will be generated. Nothing. We'll understand the requirements and then throw this out. This will not be the final system. So this is called throwaway prototypes. You can either make your prototype the final system or you can throw away your prototypes. Two types of prototyping here. What are the problems of the evolutionary development of prototyping? Can you When will you use this model? Evolutionary development. Say if you are building a website for Rivera. It's a small project and you have your faculty coordinator who is actually giving you approval for the website. So if you want building a site for your faculty coordinator, then you can sit with them, get the requirements, create the UI, get the final system. So mostly for UI and for small scale systems, you can go with fully exploratory development. When you go with a bigger system like a banking system, two major problems. Client is not free. Can you go and sit with the bank manager and say, tell me, I'll keep on coding. He'll say, please get out. That will happen. So for larger systems, this is not really applicable for building the entire bank management system. That is one thing. Another problem with the evolutionary model is, if you sit with your client and then you show him immediately forms like this, what he will think? Software engineering is really easy, man. In 2 minutes, you build the system. You will get a feel that you are already done. And if you say you need another 6 months to complete this, he will be like doubting you. Something is fishy. You already finished it so easy. And now he is saying another 6 months time he needs. Another problem with evolutionary modeling is, you need a person with so many skill sets, right? You should be very good in communicating with the client, understand the domain, very good in creating the forms or building the system, testing it. So you should have multiple skills when you are working with evolutionary modeling. So this mostly is used for UI designing. We in our projects use evolutionary for UI designing.